wife didn't like me when I'm losing, but I've been losing.
We're not there, my
brother. We've beaten South Carolina 6 times in a row.
It's been a shitty fall.
What do you want me to do?
Cycling out, we're cycling in.
Never again.
Hello, everyone, and welcome to the Danny Ford Show, a look back at Clemson University's football game against South Carolina this past week. An arch rival coach, and congratulations on the win, and a very impressive performance for your young people.
Good win for our program, and good win for our young people. I thought they did very well in going down to Columbia and playing the football game, and the goals that we set for our football team, they were able to accomplish that in the football game.
And of course, I think most Tiger fans remember the last time you went down there in 1987. It was not a very, very good night for the Tigers, and it seemed like you just came out right from the beginning and got things going for yourself.
Well, you know, we had a great crowd down there. They had a great crowd. We did, too. And I think our football team came ready to play, and they played very well. I was impressed with them, and I'm not very impressed easily, not much that they did wrong in the football game. They were sharp, and they blocked well, and they took care of the football, and defensively got after them a little bit. And, mainly, we got ahead and put South Carolina in some disadvantages because of the quarterback situation, and we had a chance to key real strongly on their running back. But still, again, we had good play by a lot of young people, and it was a great win for us, and one that we were very excited to have won, and one that now we're in our season on, and hopefully go out and find us some high school players to take the place of those 19 seniors we have.
We're going to take a look at all the highlights, and we'll do that coming up right after this. Back to the program. Now, the first thing you're going to see when we begin our highlights is the Tigers are wearing their orange pants on the road for the first time.
Don't look like Clemson, but our seniors wanted to do it, and they don't think sometimes I have confidence in them if we don't wear them. And the pants are very special, number one, and it takes a very special football team to wear them. And it's the first time we wore them on the road, and I think this football team deserved to wear them.
Tonight we are before a jam-packed house in Columbia, South Carolina, William Bryce Stadium. Clemson, number 15th ranked in the nation, in town to take on the Gamecocks of South Carolina. Hello, everybody. I'm Ron Franklin, and welcome into what should be still another sensational evening of college football here on a Saturday night at ESPN. For these great folks in the state of South Carolina, the next 3 hours is what they actually live for 364 days a year, because they have a unique situation. There are two Division I schools in this state. And folks, you can't ride the fence. You either cheer for Clemson or you cheer for South Carolina. Tonight, the battle lines have been drawn. First meeting, 1896. This goes back so far. As Kevin says, a lot of people don't know about this rivalry. Clemson leads it 50 games to 32. There have been 4 ties. And in the 80s, it's been primarily the Tigers.
Well, Danny Ford, of course, 7-0 career record in games following an open date, and he had an open day prior to this game. Danny Ford knows how big this game is. Big game to me, too. It was the first real rivalry I ever did as a broadcaster back in 1983, and it was an emotional game then. It's an emotional game today. If you've never seen one of these, you've really missed something.
Jerry Allen to the ball game, gets the handoff, and the fact that fullback, he'll have the first down out across the 33 to the 34-yard line. Henderson across midfield, inside the 45, and Patrick Hinton finally puts the stopper on him, but that is a gain of very close to 9 yards.
That's a bad sign for the South Carolina defense. Clemson is a team that would like to simply overpower you with their offensive line. So far in this drive, they are doing that to the Gamecocks.
They're now into what is knocking on the field. Fullback, straight ahead. Tony Kennedy will have the first down, and he is inside the 40-yard line.
They have 8 big people around the line of scrimmage. They should be able to stop the run.
Second down and long. Running play inside the 30-yard line this time. As you can see, Henderson bang his fist to the turf. Trent Simpson got a hand on him. High was also in the area.
Again, the key is the center and the two guards. They do a tremendous job inside. Watch the middle people in the front there. Eric Harmon, and now is Henderson, the little quick back. Jeff Flesch makes a block, and Henderson picks his way through that defense. South Carolina has to stand up the block at the line of scrimmage.
Henderson on the deep draw. Big yardage inside the 15. Moves the chains again. David Taylor trips him up.
Number 59 in the white shirt, Jeff Flesch against 44, Joe Reeves. Look at the steel block. You have to come up and meet that block if you're a linebacker. Hank Phillips helping out there with the block to center. But if you're a linebacker, you need to read it quicker. Get on that guy and get rid of him. Don't give him the angle to cut off.
Allen in the ball game has the handoff inside the five. Touchdown Clemson.
Just watched it. I think it was a 14-play drive. You're going to see it from behind Joe Reeves. Great running play. Terry Allen. A lot of room. Actually, there was a huge hole there, and then his momentum just carried him in and over the official.
The umpire scored with him. Gardocki to try to make it 7-0 Clemson. He's perfect. 8 minutes. 49 seconds showing on the clock in this opening period, and the Tigers, 14 plays, go on top. Brooks flip back. They fake the reverse. They're going to go long, looking for Brooks, and that is going to be intercepted. Jerome Henderson, return at the 40, steps out of bounds at the 46-yard line. So, the South Carolina offense that had to sit on the bench for so very long is going to go have to sit for another length of time.
Well, this is exactly, Ron, what South Carolina needed to do, and it would have worked. It's a fake reverse to Macy, and this ball, this is a touchdown. This is wide open, but the ball floats on to Macy, to Henderson. Now, that ball, he was wide open on the inside on the post. He threw the ball inside and way overthrown Henderson. All he had to do was catch it.
Henderson gets outside, breaks the tackle, and he is out across midfield. That's going to be a gain of about six. Corey Miller making the play defensively. There's Henderson on the sideline who made the interception just a moment ago. And Todd Ellis, gentleman with the crutches.
We're the up-and-coming team.
Allen at fullback, breaks it in. Has two men to beat, and he is inside the 30, down to the 26. 27 yards, and Danny told us last night he might cross him up by using him at fullback.
This guy, he's too quick. He gets to the line too quick. Look at the splits again. See the separation between the linemen. Straight blocking, overrun by the linebacker. And Allen, I'll tell you what, you don't want to give him the smallest hole, much less a hole that big. He's in the secondary, and he is trouble.
The 17, David Taylor, the strong safety, makes the stop. And on first down, Clemson has been chewing up the yardage. Fullback right into the middle. He'll have the first down, Tony Kennedy. Boy, what a surge by that offensive front.
Well, look at the splits now. They've tightened their splits down in short yardage. They're very close together, and they're just going, again, straight on blocking. They get Kennedy behind those big linemen, and he's just pushing them out of the way. Carolina has to find a way to pile it up in the middle and get their linebackers involved in the tackling.
Flesch, Hank Phillips, Bruce Bratton blocking up front, doing a great job in that last play. This is Kennedy, breaks it open at the five, and he is down to the one.
Patrick Hinton said that I just let my linemen keep these guys off of me. Well, it's not happening tonight. 46 is Patrick Hinton, and he's getting blown out. Look at this. The center is loose. Now, Hinton caught up with the center, and here comes Kennedy cutting back. Good cut back into the secondary again.
Tigers lead. We're about to go under 5 minutes to play opening quarter, and again, they are knocking on the door. Allen, right side. Touchdown, Tigers.
Touchdown, Clemson.
Patrick Hinton gets in on this play, number 46. Looks like they knock him sideways. It's whether or not the ball crosses the plane here from right down the goal line. Watch 46. Left center of your screen makes the hit. And then they drive him horizontally across the goal line. A tough call. Official said he was in.
Chris Gardocki, who is 33 of 33 on the season, tries to put Clemson up by 14. And the left footer boots it through, so let's take a break. 4:53 left in the first period. Hang on to the Tigers. Well, if he just walked into the living room, that score is correct. In fact, South Carolina does not have a yard in the ballgame yet. Danny Ford, what's his record after having a week off? 7-0. He's never lost one. And I'd say they're pretty doggone well prepared tonight, wouldn't you?
You know, absolutely. I don't think people realize around the country, I hope I'm not insulting anyone, what a great coach he is. Clemson, classic Clemson drive after a turnover, 8 plays. 54 yards, 336 is a little short. This guy has been around a lot of years, and this team, year in and year out, was 8-9 games. They're just tough, and they are physically tough, Clemson.
Pitch comes to Green. New blockers in front, spins off a couple of tackles, and then Brewster is there to knock him down. Coming from the middle, DeMacy's pass is partially tipped. Rush the intended receiver. And now the crowd is booing, but once the ball is tipped, partner, that receiver is fair game. The crowd didn't understand that, I don't think.
They're booing for that. They're also booing because when Rush was on the ground, Ron, Lott was on top of him and wouldn't get up. And when he did get up, he gave him a little shove. Lott, these guys know each other. They go to high school together, and they play each other for 4 years, and there's a lot of intensity and emotion here.
Colin Mackey to attempt a field goal. His longest is 48. He's 12 of 18 on the year. This is a 47-yard attempt. No real wind as a factor. Kick is on the way. Does it have the distance? No. Just short. Allen breaks off one tackle. Has 10, has 15. Counted off at 17 yards in the play. Boy, he has been simply unstoppable tonight.
Well, I don't know if they, college football, if they buy dinners for their offensive linemen, but they sure ought to. Look at the blocking for Clemson. And look at this hole for Terry Allen. He sheds one block and then he's loose. 6 carries, 65 yards, but this offensive line of Clemson is doing a remarkable job.
Well, the 1-2 punch has been Henderson and Allen. Tony Kennedy has run well, but also Allen has run both tailback and fullback. Here he comes again. Breaks off a tackle again, and he will have him punt. Chris Simpson, a senior out of Atlanta, finally put the stopper on him, but it's out at the 46-yard line.
Gamecocks are going with a trick defense. 51 is Tim High, the middle guard. See him to the right of your screen, a little bit back from the line of scrimmage. They've got him in kind of a flex. And now they have him on a stunt. The Clemson picked off the stunt. High, 51 runs out of the play. And Allen runs right at the bubble. No one there. And then a little bit further. They need to take those gaps, force them to close the gaps down.
Well, you can see the play selection. As Henderson gets the handoff, a little counter move. Inside the 25 to the 23-yard line. David Taylor stops him, but it's a gain of 18. Counter back, and that's what happened. Henderson had a huge opening. This time, Terry Allen, and he will maintain his average at over 10 yards. He is going to have another Clemson first down.
No boy. Block over there, Bratton and Fletch leading the way. I asked Danny Ford one time, would he rather have a quarterback or an offensive line? He said, I'd take the offensive line. 76, Harmon. Great block, field block there.
Gardocki comes on to attempt the field goal, and it looks as though it's going to be in the vicinity of 27 yards. On the year, 19 of 25. Certainly one of the best kickers in the nation. 28, they now say. They've moved it back a yard. Punter and place kicker. Perfect. 9:15 left until halftime. Clemson has not looked back. Turner. Good. I'm sure he is saying, I should have given it to the fullback. And as he went to the second option, it was to be engulfed by Otis Moore. Fake to Green as he rolls it out. Wants to run, and he's going to be hammered down for a four-yard loss by Vance Hammond.
You can see the frustration on Turner's face. When you ask the coaches about Turner, the word that came out mostly was rusty. A very fine athlete, could be a very good quarterback, but rusty.
Rocco swings it out, hands it to Gary Cooper across the 35, pushed out of bounds at the 39 by Leon Harris.
Wide receiver Rodney Fletcher is the leading receiver on the team. This is Gary Cooper, but they will throw to wide receivers when they think they can get away with it. And here, of course, they think they can. Anytime you rush the ball 32 times, pass twice, and are up 17 to nothing, you ought to be able to complete a pass.
Reggie Lawrence comes in a tailback. He gets the ball. He's going to throw a halfback pass. Wide open is Cooper. He's got it inside the 20.
You could say this is Leon Harris's fault, but remember, the offensive line of Clemson has controlled this game. They're showing pass. Maybe Leon should have seen this as an option. This is wide open, folks. Cooper was even more wide open than that. To Harris's credit, he gets back and he makes the tackle before he gets in. But again, any time a team establishes the run the way Clemson has, any kind of pass should be open.
Crowd has been silent. Sigurd has to hurry. 25 second clock down to two. They get it off with a running play straight ahead inside the 15-yard line. And Reggie Lawrence, the junior out of Jacksonville, Florida, the third tailback that the Tigers have used tonight, has the game.
Well, that play, more than anything, shows you why the option pass would work. When Clemson needs 5 yards up the middle, they get them.
17 to nothing. Tigers lead. Bootleg. Morocco has a man open. Touchdown, Rodney Fletcher.
Again, it's going to be Leon Harris in man coverage. They're going to have a drag pattern here in Morocco with the fake. Again, play action. You have to respect it. That leaves that underneath open. And Rodney beats Leon Harris across the field, uses the great speed. Morocco, that's why he has that great passing efficiency, because when they throw, everybody's looking for runs.
Rodney kind of carried it up on top of the shoulder pads for a couple of yards.
Yes, he did.
Gardocki. Keeps his efficiency alive. Perfect on the year, 24 to nothing, as you get one more look as Fletcher scores. DeMacy going long, put it up for grabs, and it's intercepted by O'Neal, his seventh of the year. Flag comes down at the 25. As DeMacy either had it slip out of his hand, something happened, but it looked like a wounded duck. He just hung it up there.
Well, one of the more difficult things for South Carolina is that Eddie Miller and Robert Brooks are great receivers. Now, DeMacy going back, looking, his arm. He just doesn't have the arm to get it to the, look at the ball, how it's wobbling, and watch Miller. And Miller was open earlier than that, but that ball is just wobbling and underthrown, and it's going to be picked off.
Take a look at the first half stats. And that pretty doggone well sums it up. 302 to 69. Look at the rushing yardage for Clemson. 224 yards. You have a time of possession. That goes back to what Todd was saying just a moment ago. Can't leave the defense out there that long.
Well, yeah, that's a classic Clemson, outrageous offensive performance. Todd, I'd like to ask you a question, though. Your schedule. I noticed in your schedule you played five teams from North Carolina, you played Florida State, but you really all year have not played a powerful, aggressive team the likes of Clemson. I mean, this is a nationally known team for pushing people around.
Well, I think that's an important point. Size to us means so much. Usually the opponents that we play were outsized, and until we play an aggressive team like Clemson on both sides of the ball that has such great intensity and size, that becomes a big factor for us.
That's a big part of the fear of the Tigers right now.
Green tries to turn the corner, gets one block from Rush, and then he's going to be pounded at the 30. It'll be a gain of about one. Robert O'Neill coming up from his free safety spot to make the hit for the Tigers. Mike Dingle with a pitch. Airborne, and he'll be stopped for no gain. Vance Hammond, the big junior out of Spartanburg, South Carolina, reaches up and grabs on. Pressure for the outside, shovel pass, and it will go for nothing. In fact, a big loss as the marker comes down, and Vance Hammond is the man who came through and hit Pitchko. I mean, as soon as he got the football, he might have been better off just to have dropped the dog.
Well, that's one thing I'm sure Dickie was aware of there, but if you throw that ball on the ground on the shovel pass, the old Utah pass they called it, that is just an incompleted pass. And I think if he would have seen the pressure at that point, I think he thought the blitz was backing out.
Right now, the Gamecocks.
They're cycling out. We're cycling in.
Green, a couple of stagger steps, then he really gets walloped down. Clemson, those linebackers are so very quick, and that's Brewster who steps up into the hole to make the tackle. Green, gonna be hit and knocked down. Wayne Simmons, a freshman out of Hilton Head, with an excellent defensive play. It is gonna be third down and long. Todd, we saw the two sides there talking about the rivalry in this ball game. You know, regardless of the rivalry, you guys have to have tremendous respect for Clemson and for the job that Coach Ward has done.
Well, there's no doubt about that. Year in, year out, we can expect the same style, same type of intensity from Clemson football teams, not just ready to Coach Ward and staff.
Two of four, a third down conversion. Kirkland, the man who got to him first. Loss of 14. Turner never had a prayer.
The outside linebackers for Clemson, the stars of the defense, and Kirkland maybe the best of the bunch. A Turner, a former linebacker, can probably really appreciate this. He's been on the other end of this. He had a sack himself this year.
Gets the punt away quickly, but it is not very far. Only coming out now, taking the Carolina bounce out to the 48-yard line. 36 yards on the boot by Darren Parker. 24 to nothing. Clemson continues to dominate this one. Rocco will keep, has five, counted off at 10 yards as he will pick up the first down on the option as Patrick Hinton and David Taylor combine on the tackle. From the 34-yard line, first down for the Tigers. Henderson on the draw, inside the 30, down to the 29. Scott Windsor, defensively.
You wonder why I was trying to get in there and guilty of encroachment. Watch Hank Phillips, number 50. Brother of John Phillips, the great All-American. See, high, too high. And then headed in the wrong direction. See, nose guard, if he's not gonna make the play, he needs to hold his ground. Just get down on the ground and stay there. Lock the hole.
87 yards for Henderson so far. This time it is Kennedy. Breaks it out at the 20, 15, 10, 5, touchdown. From 30 yards, and Kevin, what a 1-2 punch. You keep looking for the tailback, he keeps blasting you all night, and then here comes the fullback.
And right behind that strong offensive line, very, very tough. Again, the offensive line, again, the center of the offensive line, able to make the play. And then Kennedy's just loose. If you don't have any defense up the middle, you don't have any defense. And what a strain it puts on your defensive back. You wonder, and I'll ask Todd Ellis in a minute what he would do with a running game like that.
Gardocki kicks it through, and all of a sudden the Tigers have pushed this one out to 31-0. 4 minutes and 26 seconds left in the third period. Tipped at the line of scrimmage, Hammond again. Hammond is 6'7".
This is a can't win, you know, this is a can't win no matter how well you play. Watch Ike Harrison, watch his feet and his hands on Hammond. Stays in front of him, does a great job. What happens? Hammond smart, watching the quarterback, sticks his hand up and blocks it. 6 for 10, 2 interceptions for domination.
Pressure for the outside, no place for Dingle to go. Going to be stopped at the 31-yard line. He'll lose a half. Wayne Simmons, the first man to step across and hitting. Simmons is a man, he has to play behind John Johnson, who was a terror. Simmons comes in the ballgame, and he's been an offense wrecker.
Speed, and it worked out pretty well.
Gets it away. No marker has been thrown, so they're not going to call him for grounding. And, of course, there is no in the grass. Kirkland was hanging all over it.
Give you some Levon Kirkland, of course, an outside linebacker. Let me give you some outside linebacker statistics. 174 tackles, 15 sacks, 10 passes broken up, 12 interceptions this year for the outside linebackers. They dominate the Clemson defense. Great players.
Deshaun Cameron comes in at quarterback. We saw him against Florida State. Gets his pass away, complete to the 35. Doug Thomas will take it up near the first down at the 37.
There's Rodney Williams in the trench coat, 4-year starter, and then his successor, Chris Morocco.
Junior Hall out over the 45 to the 46. I beg your pardon, Reggie Lawrence, 34. Junior Hall in the ballgame also, a freshman out of Gastonia.
Watch the block here by number 68 for Clemson, and then another blowout block. You know, Clemson, in this game, I've never seen a game where you had to get away from the inside running game to slow down your offense.
Cameron throws it complete. Good heavens, what a hit on Rodney Fletcher at the 40, and it's Leon Harris, but a gain of 15. Just listen to this hit. Well, one thing in Clemson's credit, they have only 13 turnovers this year. In fact, they're third in the nation in giveaway takeaway ratio. They hold on to the football. 15 minutes left in this one. That's the end of the third period. Clemson 31-0.
You know, we just didn't play well that week.
Well, how about this there? Here's a scary thought. The only senior on the Clemson offensive line is the center, Hank Phillips. Long is a junior. Harmon is a junior. Flesh is a sophomore. And Bratton is a sophomore. And the strength of this offense, make no mistake about it, Murray Allen, a junior, and the offensive line.
Lynch coming straight ahead. Junior Hall. Touchdown, Clemson.
Touchdown, Clemson.
About this, if Clemson want to sit on the ball, they get away from the inside running game, but you have to run it. Junior Hall behind Hank Phillips, Fletch, Bratton, and the rest of those guys, and it's wide open up the middle. They have ripped open the heart of the South Carolina defense, and the result has been 37 points. They've done a lot of it up the middle, Ron.
Kelvin Hawkins, number 62, out with a very good block. Gardocki keeps his spring alive. 12 minutes and 40 seconds left to play in the ballgame. The Clemson Tigers have jumped on top by a score of 38-0. As you watch once again, Junior Hall from 22 wants to be a doctor. Straight ahead, ball is fumbled. Clemson has recovered at the 47-yard line. Well, Ken Watson, as soon as he got the ball, got belted. And the Tigers take the turnover from them, and it looks like Luzon has recovered.
Well, Watson in his defense had only carried the ball 14 times coming in tonight. He just lost it. They went to two tight ends, tried to power the ball. It didn't work. Clemson has it again. Seemed like he was just trying to shift the ball over, and it got loose from it.
Being in motion, and they give the ball to Green in all kind of trouble, breaks two tackles, and in half the Clemson team comes over to knock him down. Kenzel Jackson leading the attack.
That's the best minus 2 yard run you'll ever see. I've been watching this guy for 4 years. When he gets to the pros, everyone's gonna say, where did he come from? This is a great back. 53 yards, and what does South Carolina have? About 95 yards in total offense, and Howell Green has 53 of them.
You're not to 100 yards as yet. I said, well, okay, but in the orange pants, they're 15-2, and that hit is blocked right down the middle. Scramble for it, and it is down at the 5 yard line. Mitch Belton recovered it at the 5 yard line. Kenzel Jackson will get credit for the block.
Belt is from Columbia, right here in town. Big play. You know, this is interesting. That, again, the line, Clemson just come right through, block the thing. Now watch how Belt might have been able to get this thing into the end zone. And his teammates are so greedy, they're all after the thing. They ran over each other and made him fall down.
Not only in Clemson, South Carolina, but down here in Columbia for the over 12,000 strong that have come in to see it. This celebration may go on into the night.
Well, not totally unexpected. Again, great blocking up front. No resistance whatsoever. Kennedy just walks in and has the word for the nation on how good he is from 1 yard out.
Gardocki tries to make it 45. And he does. So the Clemson Tigers, now with 9 minutes and 54 seconds left in this one, they got it salted away. As we look back at college football in the 80s, there's no doubt the 1982 Orange Bowl was Clemson's crowning moment. Danny Ford's club was 11-0, and only Nebraska stood in the way of a national title. Led by quarterback Homer Jordan and wide receiver Perry Tuttle, Clemson defeated Nebraska 22-15. And left no doubt who was number one. 9-2 regular season. You can see that a lot of the home folks are headed for home where it's a little bit warmer. On third down, Green breaks one tackle and will not get out of the grasp of Kenzel Jackson at the 40-yard line. Fourth down, kicking time again. DeMacy with a short drop hit. Is that a fumble or an incompletion? Yes, it is a fumble. Recovered by Tyrone Luzon.
Well, the one thing you can't do, and I know this probably hurts Danny Ford to see things like this, you just can't turn off talent. I mean, talent, they're so deep in Clemson and so young that they just come and they're overpowering.
I'll give you a good example of what you're talking about. Otis Ward's a starter. He's a senior. Chester McLaughlin plays behind him. Only a freshman. That's the ninth tackle for a loss that he has this year. So Moore graduates, McLaughlin steps in. Doug Boland is coming in to tailback for the Tigers. 3:32 left to play in a ballgame. And from the looks of Danny Ford on the far sideline, you just walked in and looked and say, wow, Clemson must be losing. Not the case. This is the worst South Carolina loss to Clemson since 1935. They lost that with 44-0. And the worst ever was 51-0, and that was 1900.
Well, going back, we talked to Todd Ellis about their schedule. I mean, this is a national team they're playing here.
total yards of the ball game, we had Clemson 355 rushing, 111 passing for a 466 total. And for South Carolina, 133 rushing, 22 passing for 155 their total.
Because at the end of the game, everyone knew that, you know, they weren't that much better than us, weren't better than us at all.
Turner scrambling, now gets it away. By Eric Jeter up the sideline, and he's knocked out of bounds, and that will do it. As Jeter with his second interception of the year, and he is only a freshman, as Danny Ford goes across to shake hands with Sparky Woods. Sparky said he knew what this rivalry was all about, and tonight he witnessed it firsthand, and it was not a pleasant experience. So let's take a break. Clemson 45, South Carolina nothing. We'll come back with some closing thoughts in just a moment. Well, once again, our final score was Clemson 45 and South Carolina nothing. Now for Kevin Kiley and our ESPN crew, I'm Ron Franklin. Let's join Bob Carpenter for our Residence Inn College Football Scoreboard and find out what else happened today.
All right, Ron, thank you very much. A lot happened tonight down in Columbia for Clemson. Very impressive for the Tigers as they handle the Gamecocks 45.
What?
With Coach Woods, here is your host, John Pritchett.
And hello once again, everybody. Welcome to the Sparky Woods Show, and thank you for tuning in on a day when, understandably, most of us are trying to recover from last night's calamitous meeting with Clemson. Coach, a very disappointing loss in a very, very important football game.
It's very disappointing. It's hurtful for everyone in South Carolina that follows the Gamecocks. It's a big ball game anytime you play Clemson. We always play in the last game of the season, so it's one that lasts you for a long time. I know that it's hurt a lot of people that came to the football game. It was a beautiful night, excited, and the pitch was high, and everyone was prepared to play, and great opportunity for a big ball game. We played very poorly. I'm very disappointed in that. I know our football team is, and we feel like we've played hard, but we played very poor. We've got a lot of work to do. We've got to get to work on it. And so we hopefully will not allow this thing to happen again. I know our football team has crossed a lot of hurdles in the short time that we've been here. Seems like each time we crawl out and feel like we're getting things rolling, then something happens and knocks us back down. This was a real hurtful event tonight, and the fact that we got beat very, very badly by a good football team and a very fine program at Clemson. Coach Ford and the staff deserve a great deal of credit. They did a great job, and we've got a lot of work to do. We've got some standards set, and we've got to go to work to try to meet them. I think our football team will take off on those weights and get in that classroom and try to do a good job to improve our program. We've got to get on the road and recruit so we can bring in some football players. So hopefully we'll not allow something like this to happen ever again.
Never again.
Give them credit. They got a good team, all three phases, and we got whipped. So on the road recruiting tomorrow, that's the way we'll change our program. And that's what we need to do, is go recruit.
Recruit.
We need to continue to recruit.
Recruit.
We're down about 10 scholarships right now because of the attrition we've taken over with. It is what it is. You don't hear me complaining about it. That's the situation we're in. We're going to continue to recruit and develop. We've had 12 seniors that did a fantastic job for this football team, and we'll continue to build the program the right way. We're going recruiting tomorrow.
Recruit.
What do you think? That's a dumb question. So it is what it is. That's where we are right now. We're a little short on defense. It's limited us call-wise. And, you know, at one point, I think we had six true freshmen on the field. We had Josh, we had Ricky, we had Rescendo, we had Ernest Jones, we had RJ, and we had Israel. So you know, guys, they're going to be good players. I just wish we weren't putting them in this situation. Not fair for them, but that's where we are right now.
I'm not addressing anything as far as that's concerned, so don't ask. But we need to get better. We had a great crowd today, and I appreciate the positivity of our fans. I know they're frustrated. We are too. But we will be better moving forward, and looking forward to getting started recruiting tonight.
That's going to close it out, Coach. 45-0 the final. Certainly the locker room last night, a somber place, especially for those seniors participating in their last Carolina-Clemson game.
John, I was especially sad for the seniors. They've been through so much in the years they've been here, and they've overcome a great deal. And for them to go out with this kind of a sad defeat is one that will last them forever. You know, the Carolina-Clemson game doesn't go away. This one stays with you your entire life. And for our seniors to have to suffer this kind of defeat and their last opportunity to play and their last opportunity to play against Clemson is one that I feel very sorry for them about. I told them that I felt most sorry for them, and I told our football team that football teaches us a lot of things. Some things, some lessons aren't as comfortable as others. I told them that I wanted the remainder of our football team to remember what this felt like. I certainly will, and it's going to be motivation for me and hopefully motivation for the rest of our football team as we get in that weight room and get in that classroom and we go about those recruit visits that we don't want to ever see this happen again.
Never again.
In South Carolina. So I'm sorry for the seniors. I'm sorry for the people in South Carolina. And I know it hurts everyone a great deal, but I know that we've got to get to work and we've got to improve on our program because Clemson's got a great football program and that's the team in the state that we've got to compete with.
Legendary. That's going to be great.